I think what we might do as well, once we get more manpower, if we ever turn fascist, I'll add three more infantry down here. Which will make... Or maybe I could do it this way. I don't know, we'll see. Just make every division just a lot more powerful. Czechoslovakia's gone. Poland seeks the Baltic. Oh, Hungary joined the Axis. Let's go over to Europe then and see what's going on. Okay, so Poland. Oh, here we go. Is this it? Fascist demand referendum. Here we go. We're fascist, lads. Finally. We've got the little fascist American flag. What are we called now? The Free American Empire. Okay, let's do this. Justify war goal. We can't. We need the world tension a little bit higher. Oh, no, we don't. We need to do this, don't we? Sorry. Let's get extensive conscription so we can make more soldiers. Now, how the hell do we get out of this? How can I do this? Okay, well, you see we've got 2 million people now. Which is good. I still don't know why we can't... why we can't declare war. I'm making another new army. I don't want them there, though. In the Canada Defence Force. Oh wait, I deselected them. Where'd they go? These three. Okay. Canada troops. Okay, you guys are gonna start defending over this side. Like so. Because they're moving units over because they know. They know it's a weak point. I don't know why I can't change this. I really don't. It says more than 15% world tension, which is true. One of the following must be true. Current ruling party is fascist, which it is. If neither of the above is true, all of the following must be true. At war, blah, blah, blah. They're all true. I think we need 75% world tension. So we need to wait until there's an actual... Oh my God. So Germany needs to do something. Like, we're getting like 1939, 1940 in Germany, so I'm not at war with anyone. We need them to declare war with someone and do something. Like, how close are they to going to war with Germany? Yeah, Soviet Union. It doesn't tell us. God damn it. Okay, well, in other news though, we've got a big population now, so we can just make loads of units. Yay. Which is good. So you guys can join up here with this lot. Okay, good. Right, so yeah, we're ready to go to war with Mexico. We just need bloody Germany to do something, or someone to make the world tension go up. Japan is still dominating China, but now all these countries should be getting fascism. So look how much democracy we gave these countries. We gave them a lot of democracy. Oh, look at Mexico. But now we're starting to do fascism. So there'll be a tiny little sliver of fascism somewhere here. Starting to go up. Because what we kind of need to happen is we need the UK to go to war with someone. Because if UK goes to war with someone, preferably Germany, that will cause all of its allies, including Canada, to go and help. And this will get all these Canadians off of the border with us and go over to Europe. So then when it comes to the time we can have to invade Canada, we can just, you know, steamroll them, basically. Which is what we kind of want to do. Okay, I'm also, we've also unlocked Marines now, so I'm going to train a few Marines. Let's have, how many is that? Let's make five Marines. Poland refuses German ultimatum, so that probably means they'll go to war now. Yep, there we go. The UK's influencing Turkey for some reason. Let's get these guys to spawn here. Can we change these, make them a bit better? Let's make them... that costs more when we do this, I think. Oh, no, there we go. Make them 3 wide. And we'll give them... Germany's at war with the Soviet Union. So we should be able to declare war now. Okay, so Italy joined the Axis as well. So now, can we justify war goal? We can conquer... Wherever, it doesn't matter, because we're going to just take over the whole of Mexico, so it doesn't matter what we're going to conquer. Police with fascists, like what we wanted. I might add some more units into the Mexican force as well. When it comes to it. What the hell is this border? Look at this. What's this? Okay, we can go to war economy now. Yay. That's good. We should really go to export focus as well. Luxembourg joined the Comintern. What? That's different. I've never seen that happen before. They usually go straight to allies. I can't believe the allies aren't involved yet. So Luxembourg must be Oh, they haven't. They just joined the Comintern for some reason. Okay. Well, Poland's gone. It was about to go, at least. Warsaw was about to be taken over. So I can't say Poland capitulated in a second, probably. Saying that though, are Russia friends with they're not friends with Poland, so the Russian forces can't invade through here. Oh, here we go. The UK are at war. And so are Canada now? Yep. I think so, let's have a look. Let's see if Canada are at war as well. Yeah, look, the troops are moving. Are they moving? Yep, they're at war. So yeah, you'll notice now all the Canadian troops will leave the border, which is great. So we'll give it a little while. And then once the world tension's up like it is now, we should be able to just justify war goal and take them over like really quickly. So yeah, we'll wait. We'll wait. Our time will come. We'll take Mexico first because it'll be easier. And once... see, there's British troops up here. Once Canada leaves its borders, we'll strike. Yeah, I think Germany's going to get beasted here. They're at war with everyone already. Like, they're so stupid. They're at war with... So they're at war with France. They're basically at war with all the Allies now. And they're at war with Russia. And they're at war with Poland. So they're just because they're fighting on two fronts again. And that's how they lost in real life. Fight on two fronts. They can't do it. Stupid. Okay, let's go to export focus like this. So what this is doing is giving us more factories. Look how many factories we've got now. We've got so many factories working on stuff. So this will all start getting done a lot quicker now, which is what we kind of want. We can still improve our Marines, so we end up not doing it, so something happened. So let's give us better Marines. Let's give them... yeah, let's make it give them an engineer company. Oh, we can't. That for now then. They're not even being made yet. Why not? Infantry equipment. Massive shortage of infantry equipment. This is really bad. These military factories are really bad. We don't have hardly any. We will. That's what we're going to build next. When we start taking over Mexico and stuff, we'll get all their military factories. Belgium has capitulated. That was quick. Netherlands is... What's going on over here? Jesus, Germany. They took that well quick. Must've been like a week they took Belgium and the Netherlands. They've stopped the over here, though, because they've moved their forces over this way. And they need Spain to join, really. That'll help them out. We should be going to war soon as well. How close are we to going to war? So, our justification here. Oh god, what's all this? Okay. We start a civil war in Mexico. Which I think might be bad for us. No, we're still declaring war. I think. Yeah, we are. We're still, it's 30th of January it'll be done. So we've still got a little while, a few more months. But yeah, so Germany at war with themselves now. And so Argentina. So we want the Argentine League to win. Create faction. Okay.
Shall we create our own faction? I don't know what to do.
Because if we join the Axis, we can beat the Allies and the Russians probably over time. Or we can start our own faction and either fight Germany and its allies, or the Allies and its allies. We're gonna create our own faction. What should we call it? Yo Mama. Let's do that. Did it work? Oh, let me unpause it. The Dawn of Yo Mama. Yeah, they joined. So now we should be able to get some other fascist countries to join. And we can get like this one to join. And we can't. Can we get Venezuela to join? No. But Peru? No. Okay, our time will come. Let's start boosting friendship with them then, I guess. Let's boost fascist population for starters. Let's improve relations with them. Actually, we get Brazil going as well. Let's boost fascism in Brazil. And I'll just leave it at that for now. What about Peru? How are they doing fascism? They're fine fascism. So let's improve relations with them as well. So we're going to try and get them in our thing. Okay, we can unlock some stuff now. So what's this? Gains national spirit. Okay. Is that some building slots? Sure. How are things looking? Yep. Should be going to war soon, hopefully. I don't know how this is going to work now, though, because we've got all this bloody lot here. We need to ask for military access. We can't. Remaining to join the Allies? Well, that's not good for Germany. They're surrounded now. Hungary are allied with them, so they're literally surrounded now by enemies. Yeah, Germany are probably going to die. I'd be amazed if they survive that. This is why we need to start attacking like quick. Argentine League are doing okay. We could send them some. We can't send them anything. Join their war. Oh, we're allies with them. That's why. We could join their war, but hopefully they can do it themselves. It would be nice. They are winning. Look, they are slightly pushing down. Power Bolivia. boost fascism. Okay, so about to go to war with Mexico. We can't actually invade them unless these guys give us military access, which I don't think they will, unless we go to war. Maybe when we go to war they will. But so far, all we can attack is this section here. That's all we can do. And the troops aren't even on that border anymore because it split the front line up, so this isn't the front line anymore, technically. So this civil war kind of ruined our plan. I was hoping it wasn't going to be so successful, like so big. I was kind of expecting Mexico to just destroy them, but they're not. They're actually winning. Like I said, hopefully we can fix this. Okay, let's slow things down then to a 2, so we can go to war now. So let's declare war with Mexico. Okay, who wants to join our faction? Okay, they want to join our faction, so let's do that. Invite to faction. There we go. So now we can join. We can just go down into their territory. Mexico should capitulate pretty soon now anyway. Okay, let's just start moving these units down here on their own. There we go. I'll do that. Didn't work out as well. The plan's kind of like disintegrated. Like these guys are still on this bloody front line, which I thought to delete. There we go. So maybe now they'll go down here. Ready to go down? There you go. Don't know why this is all the way over here as well. Because there's another front line here. Like, why? Okay, come then. Start attacking them. Should be easy now. We've got help as well. Can we have military access? Surely, because we're in their faction, we can go into their territory. We can. So why are they going all the way down here? No. It's so stupid, the AI. Like, what are you doing? I said go here. Okay. We should really put some planes up as well, I guess. Let's put some planes up. Whatever. Okay, right, let's speed things back up again then. So we're going to start pushing down, hopefully. What are these doing? Why are they so slow? Because we need these wars to go as quick as possible. Do we clear this? And because they took so long to cross the river, they're back again. They're about to go though. Bye. Come on, just hurry up and get here. It's taking 20 hours. Go on. You can do it. Great. Now push here. Okay, new focus. What should we do? Let's start issuing war bonds. I don't know why they're not in the war. What the hell? I'm just saying call these to the war. They're in the war, aren't they? I can't believe these guys haven't made it down here yet. They're so slow. These guys are doing it though. Look, they're getting this bit of land. Come on though, we're pushing them back. Slowly but surely. Like I said, it's the mountains that screw you over in this. There we go, pushing back. Thing is, we keep pushing them before they can regroup and like rearm, so help us out a bit more. You see, like, these are just instantly going down because we've already pushed them. Okay, so they're our ally now. Put a lot of units up here. Let's fix that. Let's try and cut them off. Let's try and push these units up behind them. Because what happens if you encircle them, they can't get supplies and they're basically screwed. Okay, well these guys are doing their job at least, but we can get these back over here now. Probably take me a year. Come on, walk into there, like, why does it take them so long? Look how quick these guys go, and it's taking them ages to just get into this section. There you go. Now you guys can come join as well. There you go. What's this? Someone's giving us forces. No, we don't need forces. It's fine. We need military factories. This is still so low. There it goes. Slowly pushing back. How many soldiers have we lost? Lost 19,000. It's actually really bad how many we've lost. We should be steamrolling them, but we're not. Because they've actually got a lot more forces than I expected. And they keep moving, which is annoying. Just stay where you are. Like, why do you keep moving? So look at that, though. All those units there attacking one guy, but because he's on mountains, it's so much harder. Okay, let's get radios up. We're getting there though. Mexico City's just here, so we're nearly there. Yeah, we're pushing them back now. They're all getting worn out, run out of supplies. Like two tiles away now from Mexico City. Okay, they're trying to take Mexico City, try and capitulate them, get them out of the way, get them screwed over. I think our planes are pretty pointless, I don't think they even did anything. So we've got too many here, I think, that's why. Whatever. Smile. Like I said, it kind of, our plans kind of got ruined once the civil war started. How are Argentina doing quickly? Yeah, they're pushing down slowly. Argentine League, so they can, they're our allies as well. We just need to get to Venezuela to join, and Peru. I'm trying to hopefully split up Mexico with these guys, if it happens. I don't know how it's going to work though, because they were already at war before we started. Okay, war bonds. Let's get wartime industry up and going. See, like, why are they going over here? Why is he going there? There's no reason to for that to happen. Come on, just get Mexico City. It's right there. Oh, these guys will leave him for some reason. So as soon as he leaves, we'll just start attacking again. Okay. Should be near there. About to lose that section. We just need Mexico City and we'll win. Let's just get everyone focusing on Mexico City now. How much? So we did 69% of the war goal, like participation in this war. Apparently Argentina have done 2%. And then we've lost 42,000 people. That's so bad. Come on, take Mexico City. How hard is it? Okay, we've upgraded our planes now at least. Let's upgrade our strategic bombers. So they're literally all just sitting now on Mexico City because they know as soon as they lose that they capitulate. It's fine, we've got all our divisions coming over now, so we should push them back. Here we go. 21. Come on, you start attacking as well. God, we can't even attack them. I guess I'll try and encircle them then. Is this going so... I'm really apologizing, I keep saying it, but... This should be... easy to take over Mexico. We've really struggled, which is stupid. It's okay though. We can start on Canada soon as well. That'd be easier. There we go, we're about to encircle Mexico City now, so it should be a lot easier. Okay, so Mexico City is now circled, so we should be able to just wean them out now and they should just die. There we go, let's get everyone attacking. Poland has capitulated. At least something good's happening. Oh, okay, that's Germany, they took all the states of Poland and stuff. Come on, really got them. Just there's a lot of division, they're slowly disappearing, like there's 9 left now, it'll all go down. Two left, one left, they're gone. Surely they've been destroyed. They haven't, they moved their capital. They're not giving up, are they? Oh, there we go, it's annexed. It gave it all to them? What? Oh, that sucks. Well, let's start declaring war on these countries then. Let's take Guatemala. What's this? El Salvador, we'll take those. We'll take Honduras. And we'll take Nicaragua as well. For now. We can't own our political power, we've used it all up. It's fine. Okay, so what's more military factories? We need guns. Maybe we should ask for control of the state. Can we do that? Can we ask these guys to give us some of the land? State owners, we can't. Okay, whatever. It's fine. Kind of not how I wanted this to pan out, to be honest, but should we go all with the UK? We've got loads of forces up here, man. So many divisions up here. Look how many people we got. 5 million. That's insane. Okay, well, let's move all these divisions down here onto the border of Guatemala, which is really bad for them. Because they're just going to get steamrolled, which is fine. I'm not going to call them to the war this time. I think that was the bad choice I made. Calling them to come to war with us. Okay, we can make some more ships. Just make some subs, maybe? Yeah, let's make some subs. We've got an Eastern Sub Fleet, I think. There we go, we'll have some more submarines in. Let's give them what? 10? Sure. 15, because we're making one a month, which is loads. Okay, so now we're just going to sit and wait, really, for these war goals to finish. It shouldn't take too long. It's only 125 days if you have to wait. So the 10th of October, which is pretty soon. Got loads of army experience points we can upgrade stuff on. Maybe we should upgrade our marines, give them more stuff. France has capitulated. Germany are doing really well. Logistics company. Recon company. And field hospital, sure. There we go. Prove our marines. It's making really good. There we go. What about our actual infantry division? Should we increase these guys? Add more infantry in? Is that a good idea? What does this do? God, it adds a lot more manpower. Nah, sod that. I think they're good how they are. I'd rather have more units. Wow, look at Germany! They've completely taken France. I think now would be a good time to go to war with the UK. Ireland joined the Allies. I think we'll concentrate on South America and whatever's left. Like if Britain hasn't been taken by the time we take South America, we'll go take them. Okay, we'll have some more dockyards as well. So that we can make more boats. So our fleets is what I'm proud of more than anything. It's got so many. And it's so easy to make as well. There we go. I come up over time. So look, Canada now. We've got hardly any troops on the border. Like, look at this. This division is just screwed. I don't think we need that many on here, to be honest. No, we kind of do. They've got one lock on each... that's fine. Yugoslavia joined the Allies. That's not good. Wait, well, they should take them now, I guess. Germany just needs to get rid of Romania. And Russia, and they should be fine. It's like the Allies are invading again, back in Belgium and the Netherlands, pushing Germany back, which isn't good for them. If they got Spain on their side, they'd be laughing. Rubber from the UK. We're gonna go to war with you soon. We'll take your rubber anyway. But yeah, if they can push Russia back, I think Germany will win it. Win the war. They kind of already are. They're taking out everything off of Europe, pretty much. They're just fighting back. They just don't need Denmark, because if Denmark declare war with them, that's going to be bad. I bet you Germany declare war on Denmark. It wouldn't surprise me if that happened. But yeah, hopefully we can... Guatemala. How long till Guatemala? Still a while. It's the 10th of October. It's a pretty long way. But at least all these countries will start at that time. So we'll just declare war on all these countries at the same time and push down all of them. Should be good. I'm not going to call these guys to come to war with us, because I want this land for myself. Greece joined the Allies. Italy declared war on Greece. They just make it harder on themselves. They're currently at war with Yugoslavia. And they don't seem to be winning that, because they haven't pushed them back, so... There we go, German interest in Scandinavia. They're fighting, there we go, they're at war with Norway for some reason. Like, why? Concentrate, there you go. And now they're going to fight Denmark as well. Like, why don't they just concentrate on what they're doing? Why have they got to go to war with Denmark? So dumb. So us joining the Allies right now would be really good. It looks like as well, the UK have taken all of France's territory. This was all France before, so it looks like they've handed, because once France got capitulated, it looks like they've just given everything to the UK. This is all UK now. This is all UK. This Madagascar is UK, which it wasn't before. This little bit of India, whatever the hell this is, that's now UK. All down here is like UK, Singapore and stuff. Actually, I think that might have already been. I don't know. Japan is still fighting China. Well, this seems to be going well for China. For Japan, sorry. Not really doing much. They're pushing down the coast, but I don't. They need to be pushing in, inland. I reckon Japan will lose that. And I reckon Germany will lose as well. I reckon they're screwed over. They're going to get invaded over here. They can't fight all these different countries at once. What do I know? I've only taken over Mexico. Okay, so I've set some plans up in Canada. Just so if the case they go to war with us, because we're going to declare war here. If they do go to war with us, we'll be able to just attack instantly. But these guys are ready now to take Guatemala. So you do that. Okay, we've just got to declare war on all these countries now. I'm not going to call our allies. We don't need our allies. And we want this land for ourselves. We keep calling the Philippines as our ally, which is funny. Okay, so we've got currently three wars going on. I've got to slow it down a bit just while I sort this out. So we're in 1940. Nope, not that one. Let's start on the medium tanks. You guys gonna go? Hello? No? Okay, well, what is going? We're not at war with Guatemala. I thought it just was at war with them. It's fighting a defensive war. Then why aren't they moving? Enemies cannot attack from the neutral country. Are you kidding me? So I've got to call these into it again. God damn it. Okay, now go. This is stupid. That just means that they're going to keep getting the land. Which is really irritating. Killing us though with this attrition on these mountains. It gets a bit flat down here, I think, though, so it should be okay. Wait, did that just say Argentina? Oh, Argentina won. That went quick. We need a fascist though. Argentina's a big country, we need them on our side. Otherwise we'll just have to invade them. Come on, take this place, man. It's taking these ages. There we go. Keep attacking, attack for all these countries. There you go, Guatemala's done. Conquer that. Is that ours? Yeah, that's ours. Okay, good. That's what we want. Let's take El Salvador. That should be a pretty easy takeover. I love it. We're just taking out these countries like one by one. Taking out two countries at the same time here. Like these guys just moving in, take this one, like easy peasy. They've got a lot of units El Salvador. Look, 17 units in a two-tiled country. Let's get some of these just attacking as well, just to make it a bit easier. There we go. Things easier on ourselves. They're retreating back to here. There we go. Take El Salvador, conquer them. Wait. Yeah, take. Okay. Okay, okay. Got some slide down a bit. So, all do we need supply wise? Rubber. So, I'm going to get that from the UK. We should start. Brazil haven't got that many actually. So once we go to war with the UK, we're going to pretty much lose all our rubber, because we'll lose the British Raj, we'll lose probably the Netherlands, I think they're allies now. So yeah, that won't be the best, but whatever. Next target. They're retreating already. Honduras, this is ours now. Okay, we're at war with these. We're not, okay, I'll start just fighting war with these a lot as well. Okay, we'll take Honduras. So you can pop at the state if you want to, so you can keep the state but have it under our control. Which we might do with the bigger countries. If we take Colombia, I might pop at that. I'm not sure. We'll see. Okay. Alright, you guys can start setting up on this border now. Well, they're still called the Mexican troops because they're... We should just call them like South American troops, shouldn't we, really? Let's do that. So just attack in South America. South America troops. There you go. I like stuff organised. But I'm telling you now, once we start getting into some once we start getting more and more troops, it'll start getting more and more unorganised, you'll notice. Okay, let's get an extra research slot, because that'll help us out greatly. You can see now, look at all these factories we're getting. There you go, do that. We should restart. Have we got the next fighter class yet? We have. Okay. No. I just want to get rid of these ones now. We'll just switch to fighter 2. There we go. We've got tanks. Okay. Okay, we're done. Okay. But now we need more rubber. God, it's going to be a big hit once we lose if we go to all the UK. Come on, you're going onto this border. Did we declare war these guys? Nope. And Panama. If our Marines... Have our Marines made yet? They're not. If we can get these Marines up, I'll start invading Cuba and stuff. We'll get Marines up and we'll get some divisions from the defense up here. God, look, Canada's just completely bare now. Look, there's one unit defending the border. But we're only going to attack them if the UK decide to attack us.